Good day, everyone. Welcome back again with another tutorial for fluid mechanics. Today we are going to talk about the Bernoulli equation and continuity equation. And let's start to solve the following tutorials or the problems that we have. Okay guys, so in this question we have a pipe. Here's the pipe. We have a flow Q which is coming from the larger to the smaller side. So I'm going to make sure that this point is the one. And I will say the point, then this one, point one, let me so say this is another point, point two. I will take the center line of the pipe. This is the center line of the pipe. The flow is frictionless. Frictionless flow, it means that we will not take into consideration the head loss that will be occurred through the flow of the water through this pipe. Also, it's horizontal. It means that there is no difference between the center of the points that are in the same level. The diameter is given here 3.6 feet and here is 2.4. And the pressure head, it means the P over gamma. So the P over gamma at the smaller end, it means here the pressure head P2 over gamma is equal to 15 feet. If the water flow through this cone of the rate of, so we have a Q and the Q is equal to 95 feet cube per second. What is the required? Find the velocities. So we want to find the velocities at the two ends. Find V1 and V2. Velocity at point one, here is this point, and velocity at point two at the second end point. So here is the velocity. I want to know how much is the flow velocity at this point and the velocity at the second point. Also, and the pressure head at the larger end. So we want to know, so find the pressure head. P, find the pressure head, it means P over gamma. At the larger end, it means P1 over gamma. It's equal to how much? It's a so easy equation solution. We will say that due to continuity equation, the flow at the point one is equal to flow at point two. So Q1 is equal to Q2 and it's equal to Q whenever in this pipe, because we have a continuity equation and it's equal to 95 feet cube per second. This is called continuity equation. Now, we know that the flow is equal to Q is equal to velocity times A. Now from this one we will say velocity then is equal to Q over A. And if we have for point one, at point one cent, then it will be area of the pipe at point one, and then it's equal to 95 feet cube per second divided by area of the pipe one, which is equal to pi d square. Diameter of the pipe here is equal to 3.6 square over 4, and we can calculate this one, 95 square divided by 4 divided, sorry, 95 square multiply by 4 divided by 3.14 divided by divided by 3.6 square. Okay, so 95 divided by 95 times 4 divided by 3.14 divided by 3.6 square. Now here's the flow. So V1 through this one is equal to 9.33 feet per second. The same way I can find the Q, V2 is equal to Q over A2, and here we have 95 again divided by pi, and area at section 2 or point 2 is equal to diameter of the pipe at section 2, which is equal to 2.4 square divided by 4 pi d square over 4. Now 95 times 4 divided by 3.14 divided by 2.4 square will be 21.01 feet per second. Now here's the request of the first finding. Now we want to find the also P1 over gamma, so I will use the Bernoulli equation, Bernoulli equation between points 1 and 2. So in point Bernoulli, it said that the total here are still constant for the every points. If we have in the same line, so for P between 1 and 2, the total head is for point 1, the total head is equal to point 1, P1 over gamma, that's the pressure head, plus Z1, plus Z1, it means that, let me say that this is a, if this was the head, the datum, if this is a datum, so the level of Z1 of point 1 is the level of the point 1 through from this point to this line, which is equal to the same one from Z1 to point 2 to this datum. So they have the same distance. That means this is equal to Z1 and it's equal to Z2 in the same time, because they are of where the pipe is horizontal. So P1 over gamma plus Z1 plus V1 square over 2G should equal to P2 over gamma plus Z2 plus V2 square over 2G. Now Z1 and Z2, as I said, they are the same, so we can remove them from the equation. P1 over gamma is the required by the question. Plus V1 square over 2G. We have the value of V1 already here. V1 is equal to 9.33 square times divided by 2 times G, and G in this feet is equal to 32.17 feet per second square. This is feet square, second square. Okay, so yeah, this is equal to P2 over gamma. The P2 over gamma is the pressure head. At the smaller end is equal to 15. So this should equal to 15 plus V2 square. Here we have V2. V2 is equal to 21.01 square over 2. Times 32.17 the gravity, and here's also phi square over second square. Okay, phi square over second square, and this is feet per second square. Now all the units are in feet, so in from this one, P1 over gamma is equal to 21.01 square divided by 2 times 32.17 is equal plus 15. Minus 9.33 square divided by 2 times 32.17. Yeah, so the result is equal to 20.51 feet. So as you can see, it's clearly appear that the pressure head is at point 1 is equal to 20.51 feet, and the pressure head at the point, the smaller one, is equal to 15. So that's why we have the motion from 1 to B. Due to that pressure. Okay, let us go to solve this another example. This example, we have this siphon. This is called siphon because we are going to drain water from this tank and with a path of the a line or a tube. The tube is equal is should go through a higher level, the level of water, which is a B called, and then to N. This the given value is A is equal to 1 meter and B is equal to 4 meter. So I'm going to take water. The most important thing, and I want you to understand, we are talking about a steady state. Steady state, it means that the level of water will still in the same level, not be even we are there is a draining of water water from this tank, so the level of water at M same will remain the same during the this process. So this is called steady state. And this solution will not be correct if this has not happened. So they assume that you have steady state. Now we have a pipe. This pipe, the used pipe in this one, is have a diameter. With the diameter is equal to 150 millimeter. And we have a pressure at point B, and pressure at point N, pressure at M. What is the required? We want to know how much is the flow. Find the rate of discharge. Find the Q from this pipe, and also we want to know how much is the value of the pressure head at B. So we want to know how much is the pressure A at pressure head at B. As it's clear, well, let us say this is a datum. Solution will begin from here. We will assume that this is also a Bernoulli equation. First of all, this pipe throughout the old pipe from here to there, they have the same pipe diameter. It means if we find if you find a velocity at any point of this pipe, then you can say we have the velocity and also we have the diameter of this pipe. So the diameter, it means we have the area of this pipe. Our area of this pipe is equal to pi d square 0.15 square over 4. So we have this area. So whenever you have the value of the velocity of water anywhere of this pipe, you can say we have the Q. For that reason, we will take the Bernoulli equation. Bernoulli equation between points M and N. Here's point M and here's point N. So we will apply the, because it's frictionless flow, so pressure at M divided over gamma, this is pressure head, plus Z, and Z at M plus Vm square over 2g, it should equal to pressure at point N divided by gamma plus Z at N plus Vn square over 2g. Now as this is a steady state, so we will say the pressure is equal to zero, and they have the same, and Zm here is the level of the point M with respect to the datum. You can see this is equal to B, and B is equal to 4, so that's 0 for Vm square. As it's in a steady state, so the point M is, there is no movement, so also equal to 0. That will be equal to the pressure at, which is, say, we say that is equal to 0. And Zn, as I am taking the datum at point N, so it should be equal to 0. And last thing, we have Vn square over 2g. Now, so Vn square is equal to 4 times 2 times 9.81. And this is equal to 2 times 9.81 times 4, that will be equal to 78.48 meter square second square. Now Vn is equal to the square root of this value, and it will be equal to 8.859 meter per second. And by the way, because it's because of a continuity equation, V all P at equal to V at N, and it's equal to 8.859. This is to continuity equation. And the continuity equation, and because we have the same diameter at point B and A, so the velocities are the same. So yeah, this is the first requirement. The second requirement, so we want to find the Q. Q is equal to velocity times the area, and velocity at the pipe is equal to 8.859 times the area, which is equal to pi over 0.15 square, which is equal to 3.4 pi times 0.15 square by 4. So yeah, Q is equal to 0.1564 feet cube per meter cube per second. Yeah, so this is the answer. And this is, and we want to know how much is the value of the pressure head at point for point B. Okay, to know how much is the pressure head at point B, we will apply Bernoulli between point M and B to find the pressure head at B. So pressure at M, M divided by kappa plus and Z at M plus V M square over 2G will equal to pressure at B over gamma plus Z of B plus VB square over 2G. Now we know the pressure at M equal to 0, V at M is equal to 0, Z at M is the datum of M, so it's equal to 4, so 0 plus 4 plus 0 is equal to pressure at B over gamma plus Z at M is equal to the level of point B from the datum, which is equal to 5, plus V. We know that the VM VB is equal to 8.859 from the first one, so it's equal to 8.859 square over 2 times 9.81. Now from this point we will get the pressure P over gamma. It will be equal to square divided by 4.2 divided by 9.81 plus 1, so it's equal exactly, it's equal to 5 meter. Yeah, so the pressure here is equal to 5, and it will be in negative, by the way. Why negative? It means there is pressure in negative section. There is pressure that pushing water, not like this one. There is a pressure from up to 4. So that's called negative pressure. We have also another example here. We have a vertical pipe. Let me show it to you. This is a vertical pipe. I'm sorry about the graph, but I think, yeah, this is a vertical pipe. In this pipe, we have water, the flowing of water. Okay, so this is pipe one. It says that this pipe diameter, the diameter of pipe is equal to 1.5 meter, and also we have the long vertical, yes, it's vertical, so yeah, the length of the pipe is equal to any meter. And there is a pressure head at the upper end. So here's upper. Let me say this is 0.1. This is 0.2. So 0.1 and 0.2. 0.2 upper pressure means pressure 2 over gamma. The upper pressure at this pipe, the pressure head at the upper end is equal to 6.3 meter. Of what, when the flow of water through this, such as the mean velocity, and the mean velocity in this pipe, in this section, will equal to velocity at 0.2 is equal to 5.6 meter per second. Due to this flow, due to this velocity, the pressure head at 0.2 is equal to 6.3 meter. The pipe is friction head is HF. Here, friction flow is frictional. It means that we have, due to the flow of water through this pipe, there will be a change in pressure, and the pressure there is a low losses throughout the pipe, the 20 meters pipe, due to the pressure loss. It's called pressure loss. And what is the difference between frictionless and frictional flow? The frictionless flow, you can say Bernoulli equation, and each point is equal to the same. P1 over gamma plus or Z1 plus V1 square over gamma is equal to P2, and so on, and still constant. For frictional flow, we will have to add, when I say P1 over gamma plus Z1 plus V1 over gamma, it will be equal to the head at the next point in the direction of the flow plus an amount that's called the head losses in that point, head loss of the flow of that point. It means if the flow was from 0.1 to 0.2 and I am applying the Bernoulli between 192, I should say pressure 1 V1 gamma 1 divided by V1 square over 2G plus Z1 plus P1 over gamma will equal to P2 over gamma Z2 plus V2 square over 2G plus, here is the difference, plus head loss. The losses that have been done through the flow due to the frictional losses that the flow going from up to there. So that usually the addition of the head losses to be to in that point, that is the later point or the next point to the first one. And the question is, the flux head loss is head loss is equal to 1.09 meter. Now we want to know how much is the here, how much is the pressure 1 over gamma if the flow was from 1 to 2, case Q, case 1, and we have case 2 or case B, when we have the flow down. So solution, apply the Bernoulli from between points 1 and 2. I will say first case, case 1, the flow is from 1 to 2. It means upward. I will say from 2 to 1. 2 to 1, it means the this is case B and this is case A. So case one, when we have the flow from 2 to 1, case B, when we have from 1 to 2. So case A downward, it means from 2 to 1. Case upward, it means between 0.1 and 2 when we are moving from 1 to 2. So case A from the flow is 2 to 1, then I will say 2 to 1. I will start with the first point when the flow is starting from. So I will start with pressure at 0.2 over gamma plus Z2 plus V2 square over 2G. It should equal to the pressure at 0.1 divided by gamma plus Z at 0.1 plus V1 square over 2G. This is still now, here is the fractionless, but because we have a fractional flow, so I should have a head loss, and the head loss value, it should be added to the later point, which is the second one, the final destination point, and here's I have to add the HF. Now let's start doing. I will assume the datum at that point. So when I'm saying P2 over gamma, this is the pressure head. The pressure head is equal to 6.3 meter. It's given. Z2 is the level of 0.2 from the datum, and this is equal to 20 meter plus V2. We have it. We have 5.6. So 5.6 divided by 2G, and this is, by the way, P1 over gamma, the pressure head that we needed to find the P1 over gamma, plus Z1, as I'm taking the datum at 0.1, so it's exactly on the same point, so Z is equal to 0, plus, by the way, we have the flow. We have the flow is constant through the pipe diameter, so I can say the V1 is equal to V2, and it's equal to 5.6 meter per second because we have the continuity equation. Now, yeah, V1 is equal to same 5.6 square over 2G plus HF. Here is the friction loss that we have, 1.09. And we can this is can be simplified, and we can say okay, so P1 over gamma is equal to 20 plus 6.3 minus 1.09, and it will be equal to 26.3 minus 1.09, and that's equal 25.21 meter. So in case we have the flow is from top to bottom, from 2 to 1, the head loss will become 25.6. I will apply the same equation for in case 2. Case B, when we have the flow is from 0.1 to 0.2, which means the flow is from bottom to up. Now I will start applying the Bernoulli. Then Bernoulli is equal to Bernoulli between point 1 and 2. So I will start with the first one, with the starting point, which is P1 over gamma plus Z1 plus V1 square over 2G should equal to the P2 over gamma plus Z2 plus V2 over gamma 2G, V2 square over 2G plus HF. And now P1 over gamma, the one that I want to find it, P1 over gamma plus Z1, as I assume the datum is Z is equal to start with Z1, so Z1 is equal to 0, 5.6 square over 2G will equal to P2 over gamma, and here's P2 over gamma is equal to the pressure head at P2, yeah, the pressure head is equal to 6.3, okay. Yeah, so P1 over gamma, P2 over gamma is equal to 6.3. Plus Z1, Z2 is the level of 0.2 from the datum, which is equal to 20. V2 is the same, 5.6 square over 2G. Plus now HF is 0.19. This is can be simplified. Now from this one, P1 over gamma will equal to 20 plus 6.3 plus 1.09 is equal to 27.39 meter. I hope this tutorial is clear to you and take benefit from it, and I hope you all the success, and I hope you all to be safe and strong. Thank you very much, and see you in the next lecture. Bye bye.